everyone ready? It looks like they're ready for us in there. This is a big moment.
All right, everyone. 13 years in the making. Now we get to go celebrate what all of you have accomplished. Let's go. Come on, everyone.
Rocky View Schools would like to acknowledge the land and recognize all the Indigenous peoples whose footprints have marked these lands from time immemorial. Together, we can learn and honor the ways of knowing of Indigenous peoples for all future generations.
Parents, staff, coaches, honored guests, and most of all, our graduating class to the Bow Valley High School virtual graduation of 2021. Coming in from the start of the year, I know that we had all hoped that this year's graduation would be taking place in person, in some fashion. But much like the rest of the year, we've had to adjust and adapt to the online format. While we can easily find a lot of negative things to say about the online format, I'm going to take a page out of Mrs. Sly's book and look on the bright side. For example, everyone gets to enjoy this from the comfort of their own homes. And the online format allows us all to not have to wear a mask, which is a big benefit for me as I continue with this speech. On to more serious business, I would like to start by expressing my admiration for our students, staff, and parents for the hard work that they put into this year. From the beginning, we all knew that this year, your graduating year, would be difficult. But together as a school and a community, we have weathered this pandemic well. And I know I can speak for all the staff at the school when I say that I am proud of the efforts of our students and this graduating class to keep our school safe. I never had a doubt that we would succeed as a school. After all, if you as a graduating class can survive the darkness of losing Tater Tot Tuesdays, we can survive anything. But once again, let us look at all the positive aspects this year, as it is too easy to remember the negatives. First, I would like to give a big kudos to the drama department for their continued dedication and ability to pivot with more amazing productions, where several of the graduating class took on lead roles in directing positions to make it all shine. Let us all acknowledge the efforts and accomplishments of our amazing student leadership team, as they had to face a very challenging year this year, but they succeeded without a doubt. Helping Hampers was not hampered at all by the pandemic and was successful in continuing our legacy of community support. Mr. Thompson spent more time in the classroom than in the wilderness for the first time in his career, which allowed the graduating class the honor and privilege of his witty banter every day. Ms. McLeod and her leadership team devised a wonderful trivia contest for the school, won by my class, coincidentally, not that I was competitive about it at all. From your perspective, at least, the optional diploma exams have been a big positive of the year. And lastly, and probably most importantly, pets everywhere have undoubtedly rejoiced at the amazing amount of time that we've got to spend with them this year. Graduates, your grade 9 year was also my first year at Bow Valley. We embarked upon your high school career together, and it has been a great pleasure and privilege for me to watch you grow into the young adults that you are today. Yes, we had some rough patches, and some of you definitely gave us a run for our money. but I think we've managed to make it through to the end relatively unscathed and are now able to celebrate all of your accomplishments and personal growth together. Now let us look to the future. This day marks the culmination of years of work and dedication, but is also just one step forward in your life. Once you leave these halls, you will find yourself in a brand new world, and what you do in that world is up to you. Now that sounds like a giant cliche, but in this instance, it is truer than ever. You're going to be going into a post-pandemic world, paving the way for the future. Who knows what's going to happen? No pressure. Many of you will be heading to the university or college in the fall. Others will be jumping straight into the workforce. Regardless of where you are going, know that the same skills and abilities that allowed you to navigate the perils of a pandemic in your senior year will help you with all of your endeavors. When you go forth, remember the lessons that you learned from your teachers and your peers. Be the best self that you can be, and you will never be disappointed. I'm going to leave you with two quotes from one of my favorite actors, Sir Patrick Stewart. Bear in mind, he is a knight, therefore it is probably a trustworthy source, and he would probably never lie to you. The first quote is very applicable to everyone, but particularly those who are graduating high school and moving forward in the next phase of their lives. He says, "If someone says, give me one word of advice, I say, be fearless, and know without any shadow of a doubt that what you have to give, who you are, is totally unique and not shared by anybody else." In other words, be unashamed of who you are and what you bring to the table. We at Bow Valley have been lucky enough to experience who you are, even if you might think otherwise. Now go forward and share it with the world. The second quote I want to share with you is something that I've always tried to remember when things are difficult. It is possible to commit no mistakes and still lose. That is not weakness, that is life. You will have to accept that there will be things that are out of your control. Embrace adversity with good humor and face the challenge head on. If things don't go your way, keep trying. Definitely don't do what my Social 30-1 class suggested when we started the first project and suggest crying in the corner. Talk about dramatic, but somehow they all made it through the project unscathed. And yes, that was a quote from Star Trek. You all know I'm a nerd. Don't act surprised. Bad jokes and anecdotes aside, the adversity we faced this year did not dim your strength and passion as a class. This is your opportunity to embark on something new and to use that passion to create something great.
To the Bow Valley High School class of 2021, congratulations, today is your day. You're off to great places. You're off and away. Okay, so maybe not too far away because we're actually not really supposed to be traveling right now, but hopefully that will get rectified soon. This has been an extraordinary year of the last year of high school for this graduating class, and I suspect that it doesn't look anything like what you imagined on that first day that you graced the halls of Bow Valley High School a few years back. I also suspect that it doesn't look anything like what your parents thought of on that first day that you were born. No siree, not in their wildest dreams. But I want to assure you that no matter what the circumstances of today are, the feelings are just as strong as we were all sitting together in the same physical space. You have made it. High school is done. I can imagine that these words bring out many feelings, often contrary, in each one of you. Joy and sadness, excitement and fear, pride and anxiousness. These are all okay things to be feeling. Maybe some of you can't believe that this day is actually here, and maybe some of you can't even believe that you made it. But you did. So on behalf of the Board of Trustees of Rocky View Schools, congratulations to the Bow Valley High School class of 2021, an extraordinary class in an extraordinary year who I know are going to do extraordinary things. Congratulations to the Bow Valley High School graduating class of 2021.
Ladies and gentlemen, teachers, parents, special guests, and especially all of you, graduates of Bow Valley High School's class of 2021, it is my great pleasure to say a few words in this very special occasion. You're all graduating during a chapter of human history that will be forever remembered as a time that changed the world. Your graduation may not be the one of the traditional sense, but no graduating class has ever transitioned out into this world with the experience quite like you. The class of 2021 has a remarkable and exciting opportunity to choose what the next chapter of human history will say. What part will you play? What will it say about you? If we can weather this storm, imagine what we can do with our newfound strength and resiliency. A strength and resiliency hard won through the tests of adversity and challenge your generation has never seen. Amazing things happen through crisis. We learn new ways of doing things. We learn what we can live without. We emerge stronger and more resilient to challenges we will face in the future. We shift our mindset from me to we. And finally, we remember what is truly important. So, as you step into the world, I've compiled a short list that I hope encourages you to step bravely and courageously into your futures. Number one, be willing to take risks. The biggest risk in life is not taking one at all. The greatest leaps mankind has ever made were only possible when someone took a risk. Find the courage to leave your comfort zone and create the life of your dreams. Start a business. Challenge the status quo. Let your heart direct your passion and discover your purpose. Be brave and be bold in everything you do. Number two, find your people. There are more people around you than you realize who want to see you succeed. Those are your people. They inspire you to pursue growth, enhance and strengthen your skills, and pursue the things you love in life in all areas. Surround yourself with those people who help you grow, who continue to challenge you, and who celebrate your successes, just like today. Number three, teach others. Take your knowledge and your experience and use it to uplift and inspire others. Your people will give you the gift of their time on your path to greatness, and when the opportunity presents itself, give back and offer your time and do the same. It's how the greatest of leaders are made. Number four, be your best self. What success looks like for you is defined by you. Discover your passion, discover your purpose, and let those things enrich your life. Show you on your path and make the world around you a better place. Number five, embrace challenge. When adversity and challenge arrive at your doorstep, and it will, again, embrace it. Let those moments of struggle guide you into the opportunities you never thought were possible. Six, I'm getting there. Stay with me. Cherish what matters most to you. Keep the most important things in your life a priority. Your family, your relationships, your friendships, and of course, please remember this, yourself. You cannot love fiercely until you learn to love yourself with that same ferocity. And finally, number seven, give more than you receive. There is nothing in this world more rewarding than giving. Graduates, if you're living all of what I just mentioned, willing to take risks, surrounding yourself with your people, teaching others, letting challenge and adversity allow you to be your best self, what you will give back to this world will be the greatest accomplishment of your lives. It gives me great pleasure to bring congratulations on behalf of the citizens of your hometown, Cochrane, Alberta, and of course from all of Town Council. Congratulations. Thank you for allowing me the honor to speak with you today. Way to go, class of 2021. Way to go, class of Bow Valley High School 2021.
Good morning. I'm Boss Fitz. We sniss. I'm Boss Fitz. First of all, I just wanted to say thank you for giving me the opportunity to spend a few minutes this morning to congratulate you and the Bow Valley High School students, the four tribal nation members for their graduation this year. Unfortunately, as we all know, things have changed, and the new normal, I guess, is what we're doing today. And my video message to you and the students of Bow Valley High is to continue to be resilient, safe, and follow proper Alberta health guidelines as we move forward into this year and beyond on dealing with what has happened to us during this pandemic. I wanted to say congratulations to our tribal members on this very important historical day for yourself, for your families, for your community. And I wanted to reach out to let you know that we here with the Stoney Tribe want to say we thank you for your resilience. We thank you for being able to walk into a different world, knowing that the situations that we face today, that you have been able to overcome a lot of the issues that we as First Nations minority people face in this country and in the world. I thank you for your resilience to continue your learning. I wish you well. I know that each one of you will have an opportunity to pursue a greater education learning in the future on whatever direction you may take, whether it's in post-secondary or technical institutions. Here on the Stoney Tribe, things have changed, and we believe that by having assets to help fill our capacity and our needs in moving our generation to a better place, both economically and socially, you will play a main key in the future of our community. And give thanks to the school, their organization, as well as to the parents and to the people that have helped supported our graduates complete their grade 1 to 12 education throughout their lifetime. In that, again, Isnish. Thank you.
Ambassador. Nangamba ne shinge bi hewarna. Nangamba ne washijon spain chakye bi. Apini chie unra bi ke. Hengtos dachau aeg ogini toke chanim jo eginim hewarna. Hechen ne shindye sh chigye abno. Hechen wakane ishi shin shindye shinge gijiwar. Mko chinde dacha inge gichi hne ishi ton gindakna. Eno ogihibi manku inge gijia amba ne ginne icha hewan. Hechen jei chiabi hino uningia bicha idaha nanga hamba ne ne hai hibi hina jaha open chiabi kti toada na bikti ne jo na nish miye na ish 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 oegi hibi tok ipcha hewan no hecha hana ish nish jaha ish ish do oegi hib ne nik pado bi hewan no yotab ne daha ten ish nish e chigi abna no. Today marks a milestone. It tells you how far you have come, how far you have dedicated yourself, and today marks the accomplishments of your achievement. So today I encourage each and every one of you to start believing that the future is yours. First Nations, Stoneys in particular, we've been taught by our elders to believe in yourself, to venture into this world as one. And when I say one, it means the whole community, but it has to start with you. You have to learn to and search for what your given goal and talent is, and only you will know. Today is the day that you will venture into post-secondary of your choice or the direction of your choice. But don't forget that the Creator made each and every one of us unique. Unique to a sense that we can accommodate, we can participate by helping our community, by helping one another. By your achievement, you have carved your place into where you are meant to be. Once you do well for yourself, it will reflect on your family, the community, and society. Give thanks to the Creator for the opportunity that you have by means of getting the support that you need from your parents who have been with you from day one to today. And moving forward, let's keep in mind that we can do anything we want. And in life, let's make sure that we remember there's no such thing as losing. Either we win or we learn. Each day we go, let's learn as much as we can. Each day, let's appreciate what has been given to us. Let's use it to build our strength and to build our community. And with everybody, the Stony students and all of Bow Valley graduates today, you have carved your places in our communities, especially in our families, in our hearts, and most importantly, to your minds and your hearts of each individual. Congratulations, and go forward. We're right behind you. Yes, thank you.
Tonse, my name is Donna Ross, and I'm from the Wanneroo First Nation in Treaty 6 territory. I'm also Métis. I take great pride in being an Indigenous educator and have been for the last 31 years. And so my message to you graduates is to honor yourselves in your achievement because you've beat the odds, and to honor your families, your ancestors, and all the people that you will be a role model for. And so it is your great responsibility to acknowledge who you are, where you want to go, and how to journey ahead. And so always remember that you have many supports out there. So with that, congratulations on achieving this milestone. Hi, hi.
Welcome, dignitaries, family, staff, and most importantly, graduates. It's my honor to share some greetings on behalf of the staff of Rocky View Schools. Now, today we're here to celebrate our graduates. And even though it's been a journey like no other, your accomplishments are no less remarkable. Now, over your time at school, fashion, hairstyles, music trends, they've all changed. And you've shifted from learning to read to reading to learn. And probably along the way, your favorite subject has changed too. That is for, except for a few of you. A few of you have remained committed to either recess or lunch as your favorite class throughout your entire school career. 2 points for your commitment. Now, on this journey, you've had lots of people supporting you. Your family has been there through thick and thin, and while you are transitioning to new journeys, family is always family and they'll be there for you. Take some time during these graduation celebrations to say thanks to those supporters. Also along the journey have been your teachers, learning assistants, caretakers, coaches, counselors, school secretaries, administrators. Shout out to all of our RVS staff that helped to get you to this point. Now specifically, these past 15 months have really been challenging. You've moved fully online, many of you then moved back to face-to-face, only to have to isolate multiple times over the year. And some of you just stayed online all year. Now I'm so sorry that you had to miss your grade 12 sports season, your chance to be that lead performer in a school performance or in the band, and that trip that grade 12ers traditionally go on didn't happen. Also, for those of you who missed the service project that you want to volunteer on, and even today's graduation ceremony is undeniably impacted by COVID. You didn't even get a chance to score 100% on the diploma exams. Okay, no one really missed that. Now you have had plenty of practice this past year plus of building and practicing your resilience. You're getting better at shifting, pivoting, refocusing. All of that will serve you well as you continue new journeys beyond high school. And while you've been armed with a bunch of facts and skills and knowledge, it'll be the ability to communicate, problem solve, and advocate for yourself that'll probably serve you the best. Now, in closing, we are proud of our graduates and we're really excited about where your journey will take you and the contributions you will make. Take care of yourself and each other on this journey called life.
Graduating class of 2021, congratulations, you've made it. I'd like to start by thanking the dignitaries and special guests who have added their voices to our celebration. Thanks also to the grad committee, students, parents, and staff for all the hard work throughout the year that has led up to us coming together, honoring and celebrating our graduates. Graduation is a time to pause and reflect, and I encourage everyone to take a few moments, hopefully you're with family and loved ones now, and you can take a minute to connect with them. If not, take a moment and think about all those teachers, coaches, relatives, friends, family members, everyone who had your back, stood in your corner, pushed you and inspired you to help you get to where you are today. Know too that you've inspired others. You've inspired your friends, maybe even a brother or sister, although they probably won't admit it. You've inspired teammates, classmates. You've been that ear to hear and that shoulder to lean on, and that foundation for others when they needed that extra support. You inspired us, and for that I thank you. As we pause and we look back on the journey so far, and we look forward with excitement and promise to the journey ahead, this is a thought that I'd like you to think about and ponder. First, pay attention to the past. That's how we learn. But there's a reason why the rearview mirror is small and the windshield at the front is big. Pay attention to where you're going. Destinations and goals are critical and maps are important, but be careful that you don't miss the beauty of the moment by looking too far down the road. Regardless of what the future holds, I encourage everyone to focus their energy on making each and every moment the very best that it can be. And eventually those moments add up and they lead to a rich and rewarding life. Thank you all, grads of 2021, for the moments that you've created here at Bow Valley High. We're all richer for the time that we spent with you, and I wish you all the absolute best as you travel new roads, and I look forward to seeing you tomorrow as you cross the stage here at Bow Valley. I'm very glad that we're able to share that moment with families, and I do hope that you have great celebrations with families and friends later on. Congratulations once again, Bow Valley Class of 2021. You've made it. And with that, I'd like to turn things over with great pleasure to Mr. Billington and Bow Valley's fabulous Friday Jazz Band, featuring several graduating Bobcats and their version of Joe Zawinul's tune, Birdland. Thank you.
Blackfoot staff and Bow Valley families. My name is Parker McCreel, and I'm proud to introduce tonight's guest speaker, Mr. Robert McCreel. He started out in Bow Valley in fall of 2001, teaching both math and science. Most of you, however, know him as a photography teacher or as the assistant principal. I am thrilled that he can be a part of our graduation ceremony today, and it is with great pleasure I welcome my dad, Mr. Robert McCreel.
Congratulations, class of 2021, and thank you for letting me be part of your virtual graduation ceremonies. Thank you, Parker, for the introduction. This is a very special experience for me as I have a strong connection with this grad class. The number one connection is that my son, Parker, is graduating, but I've also seen a great number of you grow up throughout the years. I've coached your soccer teams, watched you play baseball, hockey, football. I've attended your band concerts, your drama productions, and was even lucky enough to have taught you for your first 2 years at Bow Valley High School. Your educational journey has not always been easy, and let's be honest, nothing ever is. This last 18 months, transitioning to and from online learning has been a challenge to say the least. What I would like to do is take you on a trip down memory lane. Our first stop is 13 years ago, your first day of kindergarten. Come on, let's go.
There are mountains to the west. There's a purpose to our quest. Where the parkland meets the mind, that's where you will find Glenbow School.
So I'm here at Glenbow Elementary. I know that a great number of the graduating class attended here, but some of the students did go to different schools, and I'm trying to make this trip down memory lane as authentic as possible. However, I'm having a hard time fitting in the 12-hour round trip to Cold Lake Elementary. With the power of imagination, this could be Cold Lake Elementary or any other elementary school, and I'm pretty sure that you had similar experiences. Many of you have lived close enough to hold your parents' hand while walking to school. Some of you were dropped off, and some of you took the bus with your mom following close behind. Starting school was a big deal. You were on your way. As you progressed through the grades, the seeds of education were planted. There were countless book fairs, sports days, student-teacher conferences, home reading, and a lot of artwork that came home. You had your first overnight field trip to Camp Kindle, and you were introduced to your first musical instruments. In early June, you started your days running around the field collecting popsicle sticks for the Brett Binder Fun Run. You had some of the most patient and influential teachers in your first 6 years of school. Some of you were lucky enough to have Mr. G for a grade 5 teacher. I mean, who doesn't love a teacher who gives out gumballs? Right, Mr. G?
That's right, sir. Congratulations, class of 2021. I'm very proud of all of you, and I wish you all the best. I miss you all. Take care. There's enough. I gotta go. Take care, sir.
Mr. McCreel, let's keep this brief. You still have a few more stops on your nostalgia train.
Everybody at Glenbow wishes all the graduates the best. Way to go, class of 2021.
So the next step in your educational journey was middle school. You now had different teachers for different subjects and were introduced to a new concept called homework. Schoolwork picked up, and so did your extracurricular activities. Sports teams, band concerts, school clubs, and school dances. I mean, just down this hallway in the gym is where a lot of these events happened. Funny story, the gymnasium, ironically, was not where you were taught physical education in grade 8. The school was over capacity and the gym was needed for classrooms, and instead you went on a 15-minute bus ride to Spray Lakes to use their gym. With the large number of students, it meant that we needed to be 20 minutes early to save seats for band concerts. My memory of the grade 6 band concert was that all the songs sounded like hot cross buns. And it was like you were trying to see how loud you could make your instrument go. To be fair, over the next 2 years, you did show great improvement. Finally, in middle school, you got to have some choices of your subjects. You were able to follow your passions. Classes ranged from outdoor ed to workshop, and I think a few students picked outdoor ed just to be in Mr. Rowan's class. Right, Mr. Rowan?
Oh, hey guys. Mr. Rowan here. Just wanted to wish you congratulations coming this far. I wish you the best going forward. Oh, I hear the bell. Take care.
For the morning announcement. One quick announcement before our main announcement this morning, though. We would like to wish the class of 2021 a deep congratulations. We are so, so proud of you guys. You deserve to see your dreams come true. Congratulations to all of us here at Bitburg.
Here we are at our last stop, Bow Valley High School. I can remember the day you walked through those doors in grade 9. You were so lost, but after a few days you figured it out. You quickly found your passions, whether it was leadership, band, drama, athletics. There was something or someone for everyone. As you progressed through the grades, your presence in the school grew. You became a leader of Bow Valley High School. Sure, you arrived at grade 12 and things were a bit different. Should we mention health protocols? Too soon, right? But there were a few things that other grades are jealous of. Let's start with no diplomas. Also, you get to walk the stage with a close group of friends, and you can skip over any speech that was just a bit too long. Just to name a few. Your time here at Bow Valley High School started with a WOW assembly and ended with a TNT send-off. Before you begin thinking about your future, be it traveling, entering the workforce, or post-secondary, take a moment to thank the people that helped you along the way. First and foremost, thank your family. And with only a few days left in high school, take a moment to reflect on an educator that made a difference in your last 13 years. If they are here at Bow Valley, find them and say thanks. If they happen to be at another school, say in Airdrie as an assistant principal, find their email, send them a quick message of thanks. I look forward to seeing you around Cochrane and finding out what's next for you. Congratulations, class of 2021.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for having me here with you on such an important day. I would like to extend greetings to the mayor, Rocky View executives, BVHS staff, elders, grandparents, parents, guardians, and siblings. Thank you for joining us today. To the grade 12s behind this screen right now, well done. Congratulations on making it to the finish line of what has turned out to be a marathon of a school career. You have graduated in the most unique school year of our lifetimes. Everyone here today is so proud of you. I am here today to introduce the BVHS valedictorian for the graduating class of 2021. What an honor. I'm excited today to introduce you to Michaela Murphy. I'd like to share a quick story about Michaela if I could. It provides you some insight into the kind of person who is representing your class. I'm reminded of the time Michaela showed up in the PE office with the desire to start the Terry Fox Run in our school. For years, I had wondered why we did not celebrate Terry's cause at our high school. I told myself it was for elementary grades. I told myself it was a massive undertaking. And guiltily, I pushed it to the back of my mind with the things I felt I was too busy for. Michaela's confidence and sincere desire to have our school be a part of something selfless won me and everyone else over. Michaela did the same thing to Mr. Riley as she approached administration about developing a Bow Valley Sign Language course. It became apparent that to resist was futile, and equally obvious she would accept only one answer, as I explained reasons why the Terry Fox Initiative would be a real challenge. Of course, next year will be our third Terry Fox Run for Cancer Research, and our sign language course is going strong. Michaela is unique in the many lasting marks Michaela has left on Bow Valley High School. On a personal level, Michaela reminded me, no matter how busy you are, some things are simply worth doing. When you get as old and bald as I am in a teaching career, you get to meet some amazing students. Your valedictorian is one of the very best. This driven student works tirelessly to be excellent in all she does. Michaela has a long-time goal of working as a teacher helping students with diverse needs. Like many of you, Michaela's future plans are based on the desire to help and make our world a better place. Whether it is her exemplary marks, her robust and diverse volunteer portfolio, or her ability to excel in any athletic pursuit she chooses, this amazing person has truly set herself apart. What I like so much about Michaela representing your class is that all of you can find parts of yourself in who she is. It might be her kindness, or her growing confidence. It might be her drive, or it might be her blindingly bright future. Michaela represents you all so well. I'm so proud of Michaela's accomplishments and the person she truly is. Please welcome the very deserving valedictorian of the Bow Valley graduating class of 2021, Michaela Murphy.
Thanks, Bo, and good evening, everyone. I hope that wherever you are tonight, you are enjoying yourself so far and celebrating the graduating class of Bow Valley 2021. I'm honored to have the opportunity to be up here speaking on behalf of our class, and I've got to say that I can't believe we're here already. When I thought about what I wanted to talk on tonight, I realized that it's been the little moments that have stood out the most over the past 4 years. They weren't huge moments that made it into any newspaper, but nonetheless, they were memorable. I mean, can you think back to middle school when we finally hit grade 8 and the excitement we all felt at getting to ride on the back of a school bus? Or who can forget the times when things like Fortnite took over our hallways and Yannick was finding a sneaky Parker McCreal hiding out in the bathroom during science class trying to play the video game on his phone? In grade 9, I remember the great job we did at frustrating the grade 12s simply by standing in the middle of the hallways and running into them. Grade 10 was next, where I think we all took a little joy in no longer being the Minor Niners, although this was also the year where we lost the tater tots from the school cafeteria, so some big sacrifices had to have been made. Grade 10 then quickly meshed into grade 11, where classes got hard and you maybe became tempted to start Googling jobs that don't require high school diplomas, but here you are today getting that diploma anyways, so I hope those many hours of fighting to stay awake in class were worth it. It's easy to look back on this year and feel disappointed on all that we could have missed out on, but I hope that instead at some point you each choose to take a second to look back and remember the small moments that made you smile. For some of you, maybe one of those moments was in grade 10, when our entire ODL class attempted to stuff themselves into an outhouse on a camping trip, or when the drama program sold out every single night during the Rock of Ages production. Or what about those cold fall nights when you bundle up with your friends to go cheer on our football team? Or maybe for you, it was simply just walking through the hallways this September as seniors. Through all of this time, we've learned a lot of lessons and skills such as patience, because after spending 3 years of driving in our school's parking lot, we've had to. I mean, I think it's a bad sign when you're simply thankful that a grade 11 didn't T-bone your car during the middle of lunch. Hey, Shayna. Aside from this lesson of patience, our class has also learned about pride after beating Cochrane High in the girls' 2018 basketball zones. And then we got a good lesson in humility after they beat us twice in the last two Cochrane Classics. But let's just blame that one on the last two grad classes and leave it there. The third and most recent skill our class has mastered is how to mute our computer microphones and turn off our cameras on Zoom calls faster than I think any of our teachers have seen us submit any assignment before. But in all seriousness, we've been through a lot this year, and I hope we can all feel proud of our resiliency. I think we can agree that this has been a year for the history books, and certainly one that none of us are going to forget. And hey, some things are better missed out on. Diplomas, for example, are something I was more than happy to have avoided. I'm so proud to have grown up with you all, and I truly mean it when I say that this is an extraordinary class. Each and every one of you have taught me something about kindness, humor, strength, and so much more. I know that wherever life takes us next, this grad class is going to do amazing things. I mean, who can't see Brady Luft as a successful businessman, or Thomas Hicks becoming our generation's Picasso, or Sophie Harris on Broadway, or how about Justice Heather running her own stable? There's a never-ending list of possibilities for you all, and I can't wait to hear about what you chose to do in your lives at our 10-year reunion. Robert Schuller once said, "Tough times never last, but tough people do." And while my guess is he wasn't referencing a senior class in the middle of a global pandemic, his words seem to fit our situation pretty perfectly. We've made it through bad hair trends, the famous Nickelodeon versus Disney Channel debate, the Ugg boots epidemic of 2012, razor scooter ankle injuries, awkward middle school dances, and not to mention a year and a half of COVID. So I encourage you to thank all of the teachers, staff, parents, grandparents, and guardians who helped us get past all of this. Whether it was Hooper's help after class, or a laugh you had with Ann Holt, or even your parents checking up on your power school when you really wished that they hadn't, it was care like this that made it possible for us all to be standing here today. And at the very least, they all deserve a huge thanks for the teenage mood swings, rebellions, and difficulties they had to endure. Sorry about that one, moms and dads. As you now look ahead, whether you're scared of the future or eager to be out on your own, go confidently into this next chapter and remember to be kind and generous to those around you. I know that some days we feel older than we are, but we still have a whole life ahead of us to enjoy and make the most of. So when the day comes again where we can leave our house without masks, seize every opportunity you can, because we now know how quickly the world can change. I mean, one minute it was Brady Gessner running through our hallways during reindeer tag in wigs and leggings, and the next minute we're all here watching our graduation ceremony on YouTube. And if a teenage boy in leggings has taught us anything, I guess you can say that life moves pretty quickly and the little memories like this one are lasting. If I can leave you with one more final thought tonight, it is to not get too caught up in the big pictures of life, because you're only going to look back with regret to realize that you've missed out on all of the small moments along the way. And as I've said, those small moments are the ones that are going to mean the most to you one day. Wherever life takes you next, choose to be young and adventurous and make sure that you're having fun. Good luck to you all in the future, and I can't wait to see what the Bow Valley Grad Class of 2021 is about to accomplish. Thank you all for your time, and thank you to my class for the honor of being your valedictorian.
Where the heck is Yannick? We're about to go. Hey Yannick, I'm so glad that tassel toss worked, man, but hurry up, we gotta go, we're gonna be late.
Alright, I'm just getting my robes on.
Hurry up! Come on, let's go.
Alright. Up to playing my song, the butterflies fly away. Now in my head like that.
Eric Andreessen.
Levi Archibald. Braden Barnes.
Gracelyn Bartell.
Ellie Bates.
Ari Beta.
Parker Belcourt.
Jack Follett.
Jonathan Bolesky.
Hannah Forzen. Jonas Wallaby.
Jacob Bowen. Shayla Brass.
Kenton Breezeboff.
Madison Bujold.
Danica Burke.
Hannah Butler.
Zachary Butler.
Ashlyn Carroll. Eunice Kayambas.
Jamar Kalan.
Keegan Sherrington.
Ben Chudley.
Merrick Coltman.
Brooke Contenti. Nicholas Corcoran.
Amber Cowie.
Ethan Croft.
Matthew Cumberland. Jet DeVoe.
Ryan Dylan St. Pierre.
Mason Dixon.
Taylor Drake.
Adam Earle.
Jocelyn Eckert.
Connor Mbodo.
Lauren Enders.
Brianna Estriker.
Garrett Fee.
Shania Fernandez.
Haley Fiala.
Jojo Fisher Lynn.
Raina Flaherty.
Kyra Fox.
Shauna Pearson.
Jonas Fridfinson.
Kyla Fitz.
Angel Garcia.
Owen George.
Brady Gessner. Connor Gibson.
Shakira Gibson. Abigail Giggs. Jason Gillies.
Connor Greeson.
Cadence Green.
Andrew Rome.
Leanna Guerin.
Gabe Hadlin.
Malcolm Hagen.
Bryson Hammer.
Sophie Harris. Zachariah Hader.
Justice Heather. Thomas Hicks.
Caitlin Hill.
Nathan Hill.
Brianna Heise.
Sarah Hogg.
Julian Holgan.
Jabari Holt.
Kyra Hunter.
Leah Isler.
Riley Juno.
Annabelle Yonker.
Alicia Harilia.
Arshpreet Kaur.
James Kinn.
Sky Kirby Smith.
Hannah Kitchen.
Jaden Clausen.
Katie Knox.
Lee Knox.
Dominic Kotick.
Max Kruger. Nisha Leahy.
Katie Laidlaw.
Mackenzie Laidlaw. Jesse Lee.
Wilson Levisky.
Noah Linton.
Jason Liu.
Sharia Lopke.
Matthew Lowe.
Brady Lopke.
Haley McIntosh.
Parker McCreel.
Caitlin Maltra.
Charlotte Manabat. JC Mann.
Rocky Marr.
Devin Matthews.
Trayton McClelland.
Evan McFeeders.
Haley McGonigal.
Avery McGinnis.
Renee Michaud.
Christopher Mitchell.
Jessica Monzon.
Kelby Morrison.
Chloe Mullen.
Michaela Murphy.
Bryson Nelson.
Taylor Nelson.
Ben Oliver.
Jamie Omato.
Owen Osborne.
Hart Pegarrigan.
Daniel Pare.
Annika Hart.
Ethan Pascal.
Sasha Patera.
Braden Peace.
Noah Peters.
Dylan Parrott Timms.
Finn Pittman.
Jordan Cole.
Georgia Powers.
Cody Queering.
Manny Rolling Mug.
Kristen Rose.
Sadie Russo.
Morgan Rousel.
Ben Sands.
Joshua Schott.
Katie Scott.
Ankush Semwal.
Cameron Servin.
Brody Sidebottom. Nico Smith.
Caitlin St. Amour.
Catherine Sterling.
Alexa Storzik.
Jackson Streeter.
Madison Switzer.
Marie Capilau.
David Taylor.
Max Teske. Sophia Tilma.
Amelia Townsend.
Vera Vanderkran.
Carter Verhul.
Cole Verhul.
Charlotte Voss.
Tatum Wesley.
Chaz White.
Jade Widmark.
Salim Wildman.
Denver Wildman Chinique. Finn Winters. Shayna Zaharia.
Congratulations on your graduation, class of 2021. We are so happy to celebrate this moment with you today, and we wish you all the best as you move forward from high school. As we continue with our program this evening, we have some special touches to share. First, we have a presentation by graduate Jeff DeVoe, entitled To Those Who Walked This Journey With Us. And then we have a fun staff video collaboration made especially for you graduates.
Good evening, everyone. I'm so grateful to be here with you tonight. To our families and our Bobcat staff family who have walked this journey with us, we thank you for being a group of people we can rely on, especially when things get tough. We thank you for being the people we can ask for advice when there are answers we need. We thank you for giving us guidance on what path to take when we are unsure of the road ahead, but also for supporting us and cheering us on for the paths we've chosen for ourselves. There are so many things we can thank you for, and that's why you were so deserving of this moment of gratitude this evening. To our Bow Valley High School staff, you have helped each one of us find our passions over the last 4 years. You've pushed us to take classes that inspire us, you've motivated us to get involved with extracurricular activities that engage us, and most importantly, you've been able to support us along the way, no matter what. In our grade 9 year, Mrs. Carlson and Mr. Thompson with the student leadership team inducted us into our first week of welcome. Now who could forget that? Our staff really is the greatest at getting school spirit pumping. Because of our staff pursuing their passions, students can take a range of classes from music to art to drama to outdoor leadership to game design to cosplay, fashion, or foods. The variety is endless. And the staff teaching these courses overachieve in providing opportunities for learning, but also for self-growth. The variety of social studies and science courses provide a challenge to us so we can focus on improving ourselves and also looking at how that applies to our larger world. I would be remiss if I did not give my thanks to Mr. Ho, who was there to make our students better citizens that carry themselves with integrity while delivering an outstanding curriculum. We know that he is out there doing the same thing at Bird Church. English classes with Sly and Galloway helped us all to grow as writers, supporting us as learners and people in finding our own voices. Like many BV staff, Mrs. Sly's ability to be adaptable in teaching and learning, especially if something needed to change for us, gave us a model to follow so we had assistance to tap into our own learning needs and strengths, which helped us to learn how to self-advocate. The passions of staff were instilled into us, so now we can take them into our own futures. This is also true for the extensive extracurricular programs we've been able to have during our years at Bow Valley, which provide an additional set of skills for success. Performing arts is a place many of us have learned to be more confident, how to work as a team, which is very true in athletics, and to hone creativity and extend that skill beyond the stage. Our theater teacher, Mrs. Fosham, for sure, is someone who knows exactly how to push an individual to improve in areas that are new to them. She is so good at picking out what will challenge people and how they can grow from it. Please know that we are grateful for that. Mr. Billington as well empowers musicians to do their best and to put their hearts into the music. And our athletics programs offer wellness and sportsmanship lessons that we will carry forward with us for ages. And we cannot forget the guidance of Mrs. Higgins, Mrs. West, and Mr. Reese over the years, assisting us with post-secondary supports and advisement, which will help many of us begin our new journey, starting in the fall. Mrs. Demio and Mrs. Holiday have also been key guiding lights for many of us, helping us to grow and engage in these areas of passion. Each one of us has those key staff memories and connections that have made our high school years what they are today. Even though Bow Valley has grown in size over our 4 years of high school, the connections are so meaningful and so strong. The bonds between students and staff with our grad class are so strong because of how much care and compassion you each give to us here at Bow Valley. We are so grateful for your commitment to providing the best education possible, all while being there for your students in whatever way was needed at the time. To our family members, obviously we would not be here without you. There are just too many things to mention in this exact moment, but I would like to say thank you for a few key things on behalf of myself and Bow Valley's grad class of 2021. From driving to performances and athletic events, committing to pickups and drop-offs, and ensuring that you were there to cheer us on every step of the way, we knew we could always rely on you. We know you always want what is best for us, and you are looking to help us be successful. We know that you were trying to help us see the best in ourselves as well. You have nurtured us through 13 years of high school, not 13 years of high school. You have nurtured us through 13 years of school, helping us to grow into who we are and celebrating the people we are and are becoming. You have sought to help us recognize our strengths so we could build our own characters. You have helped us become resilient, courageous in the face of adversity, and helped us to see the value of using our setbacks as moments of growth. The love and support you offer us is priceless. Fellow graduates, I'd like to remind you to take a moment to reflect on the wonderful people you have relied on throughout the years. They're part of the reason you've come so far in such a short amount of time. And to our staff and family members, we cannot express enough gratitude for all that you've done for us. We will keep you in our hearts for years to come. Thank you.
Hey, yo, big wave. Turn the mic on. Start my truck, let's all jump in. Here we go together. Nice cool breeze and big palm trees. I tell you, life don't get no better. Talking about hey now, hey now, hey now, hey now. Aiko, aiko, ane. Chucky mo fina, ane. Okay, you're my manguele. Step on the dancing floor. Hips be winding, DJ rewinding. Take it to the island way. Okay, yo baby mama. Put on your dancing shoes. One drop it, pop it low now. Take it to the max now. Jam in this small jam way. Jam in this small jam way. My bestie and your bestie dancing by the fire. Your bestie says she want parties, so can we make these flames go higher? Talking about hey now.
Straight up, right hoochie mama. Make me party non-stop in a island banda. Swing those hips and back it up to me ragga. A chance for party ladies, do the doggy doggy. I'm jamming island reggae, rapping blue, green and yellow. Me jumping on me beat, make a slow wine for me baby. Speakers pumping, people jumping. We jamming the island way.
Shout out to the good time crew all across the islands. Grab your shoes, let me 2x2. And now we're shining bright like diamonds. Talking about hey now.
Take it to the max now, jump in the small jam way. Wind it!
Wind up, go down. down, wind up, go down. Twist your body back, back.
We go
left, left. We go right, right. Turn it around and forward.
Wind up, go down again.
Wind up, go down. Wind up, go down. Twist your body back, back.
Twist it back.
We go left, left. We go right, right. Turn it around and forward.
My bestie and your bestie dancing by the fire. Your bestie says you want parties, so can we make these flames go higher? Talking about hey now,
hey now,
hey now. Says she want parties, so can we make these flames go higher? Talking about hey now,
hey now,
hey now,
hey now.
I go ane. Chokin' mo fina anane. Chokin' mo fina ne. Start my truck, let's all jump in. Here we go together. Nice cool breeze and big palm trees. I tell you life don't get no better. Talking about hey now,
hey now,
hey now,
hey now.
I go ane. Chokin' mo fina anane. Chokin' mo fina ne.
Okay, your mama nguele. Step on the dancing floor. Hips be winding, detail rewinding. Take it to the island way.
Start my truck, let's all jump in. Are you guys not in?
Take it to the max now. Jam in the small jam way. Jam in the small jam way.
My bestie and your best.
I would like to take a moment to thank this year's graduation committee, who worked very hard and put in many hours to make this year's grad what it is. It would not have come together the same way without you. Thank you especially to Grad Chairs Mrs. Heather Holliday and Ms. Kathleen Elliott for their leadership, energy, strategic thinking, and commitment as they went above and beyond to make this milestone moment special for the class of 2021. And thank you to all those who contributed and helped to make this event something to remember. It is truly appreciated. Graduates, as your grad quote states, so many of our dreams at first seem impossible, then they seem improbable, and then, when we summon the will, they soon become inevitable. As you go forth from your days at Bow Valley High School, we hope you will live your dreams as they are not as impossible as they may first seem. You each have the will in you to do whatever you want to do. We look forward to all of you keeping in touch to let us know what you achieve. After all, once a Bobcat, always a Bobcat. Now go forth, graduates, and make it so.
Well, graduates, congratulations.
It's your time now. Let's go celebrate.
Follow us.